Welcome to How to Expat. My name is Tasha.
My name is Sam, and at How to Expat, we help expats relocate. This video, we want to talk about expectations versus reality living here in Colombia. So when we came, or when we planned to come, we thought, yeah, that many things will be different. So we will talk about a couple of topics today. What's turned out to be very, very different from the expectations we had before coming. So safety, let's start with safety.
Okay, so safety, expectations. We heard from our family that have never been to Colombia. You get kidnapped, you have to watch out because people gonna rob you and you're gonna get killed and that kind of stuff. How does reality look like?
Yeah, reality is pretty much for us Swiss guys, it's a little bit different because we don't have this big kind of cities. But even when we travel to the US, like New York or LA, like it's pretty much the same thing here in safety-wise. So it's really not too big of a deal. What we expected that we have to, it's kind of the wild, wild west. It's pretty any other big city in the world too. Mm-hmm. Then development, so the developed, how developed it is here. So for example, I brought my big old survival knife and things like that, and the mosquito net, and we thought we're gonna live in the jungle and stuff when we thought about living in Latin America.
Sounds so ignorant.
Exactly.
But that's really what we thought we would do.
Exactly. So yeah, the reality looks quite different. So when we came here, actually we stayed right next to one of the most luxury malls here in Medellin, and that was such a stark contrast to what we thought Latin America would be like. So
we don't even have such nice malls in Switzerland.
Exactly.
We were like, this is Colombia? They talk about a third world country and stuff, but what?
Exactly. It was just crazy. So it's way true. Different. Then what did we think about the unpunctuality? You just hear people talk about the Latinos are unpunctual. How was that for you?
Okay, so being raised by an African mother, I know the African time, which is being late, and it's at least an hour usually and longer, or they're not gonna show up at all. So I pretty much expected the same thing to be here. But here, well, I have to say that's mainly Medellin, because when you go to the coast, that changes totally. But in Medellin, in general, people are punctual, and when they're not, it's maybe half an hour, maybe you have to wait. But we heard stuff like they're not gonna show up, mañana, that kind of thing, but it's not really a thing here in Medellin. So yeah, reality looks different. Well, Latin time exists, Colombian time exists totally. But we're not talking about tomorrow, we're talking about maybe 30 minutes to an hour. Yeah. That's at least what we experienced so far.
Exactly. Then the blackouts. So we thought when we left Switzerland, we have a blackout maybe twice a week, once a day, something like that. Infrastructure will be not so good. But how many blackouts did we have in the last year?
How many blackouts did we have? Three? Four?
Yeah, maybe three, four, so not really too much.
Yeah, and it was like a thunderstorm outside and stuff. That's what caused it. So normal days, four times
that's
a year,
not a
maybe.
Thing. Yeah,
but
exactly.
In Switzerland we had maybe three times, so it's not really like that much more.
The next thing is hot water. So I thought when I left Switzerland, I will have had my last hot shower for the next couple of upcoming years when we travel and live in Latin America. But how is it actually?
Well, when you go to the coast where you have like 90% of humidity, you don't want to shower hot and you can't. But here in Medellin, in Bogota, like in the Andes where it's like tropical weather, you always have hot water. Like you don't have to shower with hot water, but you pretty much always have it.
Exactly, yeah. Depends on, if you book, let's say, a really crappy Airbnb, they might not have it. But everywhere where we stayed, hot water was always available.
Yes.
Then what about the tap water? That's something that applies more or less just here to Medellin and maybe to Bogota. Tap water, we thought we have to buy like these big water bottles. That would be one of our weekly tasks and stuff. Mm-hmm. But the fortunate thing here in Medellin is that we really have drinkable tap water here. So that's a good thing. Then another thing is that when we did research and stuff, especially about Medellin, that's what was one of the reasons why we almost skipped it, not going to Medellin, is that we thought it will be full of gringos, because we read, Medellin is full of gringos and stuff. So how is reality really like?
Not really close to what people try to portray it is. Well, yes, there are foreigners, not only Americans, but Europeans from all over the world. But there's a specific place where you have all the hostels, the hotels, and like the party area, but like the amount, the percentage is really, really small. So when people tell you, yeah, there are so many tourists, well, they were staying in a touristy area, which is Poblado, which is around Parque Lleras. But in general, still, you have way, way, way more Colombians here than foreigners.
Exactly. And then in Bogota, for example, you will find more foreigners there in general, but it's not a lot either. And then, yeah, Cartagena, the tourist spots. But other than that, Colombia is pretty like free, let's say, of any kind of foreigners or big tourist heavy activities, next to the one little spots in each city, which is, yeah, just touristy anyway. You will have that in any big city.
Yeah.
So, I think that's pretty much it for the couple of points we wanted to share now. Maybe we'll have a part two soon coming up if we see that you guys like this video. I think that's pretty much it. Do you want to add something?
Maybe you want to, you guys want to tell us what your expectations are. In case you have never been here, you can share your expectations and we can tell you about the reality. Mm. And also if you have such like examples, like we have expectations versus reality, if you had experiences like that. So let us know in the comments down below.
Exactly. And if you want to find out more about how life could be in Latin America, don't forget to check out our free ebook. It's linked in the description down below.